السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، الصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، أما بعد. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, in this very brief talk, I will try to focus on two, three important questions which are addressed by the verse number 185, surah number 2, surah Al-Baqarah, which begins, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن الآية الكريمة. The first question, why the month of Ramadan? We all know that the month of Ramadan is very special because of fasting. But why the month of Ramadan was chosen for fasting from among all the other months? The answer is here, شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان فمن شهد منكم الشهر. It's because the Quran was revealed in this particular month that we have been asked to perform the obligatory fasting in the month of Ramadan. For a true believer, for a Muslim, there can't be anything more important gift from the Allah the Almighty than this book of guidance, which is the real reason for his success in the hereafter. For a Muslim, for a true believer, his success in the hereafter is the most important thing in his life, because if he wins the entire world but he fails in his hereafter, it accounts for nothing. In one hadith, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says that لَأَنْ يَهْدِيَ اللَّهُ بِكَ رَجُلًا وَاحِدًا خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا وَمَا فِيهَا. If you can bring any one person to hidayah, it's better than winning the entire world. So, of course, to succeed in the hereafter is the most important thing, and the book which is the real reason for this success is the most important gift from Allah the Almighty. And it's in order to be grateful to Allah that we have been asked to perform the obligatory fasting in this month as a sign of thankfulness towards Allah. The Quranic scholars, they speak of two different phases of Quranic revelation. The first one, which took place on the Laylatul Qadr, was the revelation of the Quran in its entirety. And then the subsequent verse by verse revelation of the Holy Quran from the first guy to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam by the means of the archangel Jibril alaihi salam, it took place, it started on 17th of Ramadan. So the question can be, why Quran, which is the word of the Allah the Almighty the Eternal, how can it be time bound? How can it be limited to a particular month, or how can it be limited to a particular space or time? The answer is, Quran, when it was in the preserved tablet, when it was in the Lawh al-Mahfuz, of course it was timeless. But when it comes to the limits of this material world, of course it has to be bound by a time. And that's commencement of these both revelations took place in this particular month of Ramadan. Now, apart from being grateful to Allah, all the ibadat in Islam, they carry some inner meanings which a believer and a worshipper is supposed to attain. The most important thing being to purify one's inner soul. We can see that in all the ibadat in Islam, whether it is prayer or whether it is fasting, whether it is zakah or hajj, we can see that the most important thing in all this ibadat is that one has to purify his soul. In hadith, we can see that the soul of a person will get stained. In one hadith, we can see Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, تُعْرَضُ الْفِتْنُ عَلَى الْقُلُوبِ كَالْحَصِيرِ عُودًا عُودًا. The temptation will be exposed on the hearts like the reed mat is woven one after the other. فَأَيُّ قَلْبٍ أُشْرِبَهَا نُكِتَتْ فِيهِ نُكِتَةٌ سَوْدًا وَأَيُّ قَلْبٍ أَنْكَرَهَا نُكِتَتْ فِيهِ نُكِتَةٌ بَيْضًا. Whichever heart is impregnated by these sins and temptations, there will be a black dot put in it, and whichever heart which rejects these sins and temptation, a white dot will be put on it. Hatta tasira ala qalbain. The result will be two types of heart. One will be white like a white stone, and another will be blackish like a pot which is upside down. So this type of heart which is impregnated by the sins, by the temptations, it has to be purified. So our ibadat, our fasting, our salah, our zakah, our hajj, all these are the methods of purifying our inner soul. Commenting on the importance of fasting for purifying the soul, the famous Indian scholar Shah Waliullah Dahlavi, he writes in his Hujjatullah al-Baligha, and he says, "As-sawmu tiryaqun mujarrabun li sumumin nafsaniyya." Fasting is the well-proven antidote in order to wipe out the toxins of the inner soul. So in Quran also we can find that kutiba alaykum as-siyam kama kutiba al-ladina min qablikum la'allakum tattaqun. Oh, who you believe, fasting has been made obligatory upon you like it was prescribed on the people before you, so that you can guard against evil. So the intention behind the fasting is that we should be able to protect our souls from the sins. And about the prayer also, we can find the same thing. Inna salata tanha anil fahsha'i wal munkar. Of course, the prayer, if you perform it in the right way, it can protect you from the evil doings. Once the Prophet ﷺ asked his Sahaba, if there is a river flowing on the doorstep of one of your house, and suppose that you take bath in that particular river 5 times a day, will there be any dirt left on your body? The Sahaba replied, no dirt will be remaining in his body. Prophet ﷺ told, that is the likelihood of the 5 times prayers a day. Whoever performs the 5 times prayers a day, no stain will be left in his body. And we know that about zakah, the very word meaning of zakah itself is the purification. And about hajj also we can find that Prophet ﷺ has said, man hajja falam yarfuth walam yafsuq kharaja kayawma waladathu ummuhu. Whoever performs the hajj pilgrimage and he doesn't commit any sins, he doesn't commit any bad words or deeds, he may return from his hajj like on the day when he was born from the womb of his mother. So behind all the ibadat of Islam, we can find the inner meaning of purification of one soul. And especially this is true when it comes to the fasting. But remember, our fasting has to be fasting. It has to touch the soul. Prophet ﷺ has said, مَنْ لَمْ يَدَعْ قَوْلَ الزُّورِ وَالْعَمَلَ بِهِ فَلَيْسَ لِلَّهِ حَاجَةٌ فِي أَنْ يَدَعَ طُعَامَهُ وَشَرَابَهُ. So of course, we have to try our best to make our fasting meaningful. May Allah bless us. Ameen. وَآخِرَ دَعْوَانَا الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.